Good morning, dear children. Today we are going to learn long answers of the lesson 5, Water on Earth. Children, all of you open your worksheets. See, in our previous classes we have completed meanings, fill in the blanks, choose the correct answers, match the following, and short answers of the 5th chapter, Water on the Earth. And in today's class, we are going to learn long answers. Okay. See the first one. Explain the process of water cycle. Explain the process of water cycle. See the first point. Water vapor goes up in the sky and forms clouds. First of all, due to sun, the water gets heated and water vapor forms. So, this water vapor goes up in the sky and forms clouds. Second point, when these clouds cool down, it rains. When water vapor goes up in the sky and forms clouds, these clouds will cool down. And when the clouds cool, it will start raining. Okay. Now, see the third point. The water returns to the water bodies on the ground. This process is called water cycle. So, when it starts raining, the rainwater comes down to the water bodies like oceans, lakes, wells, rivers, ponds and all this. Okay. So, the water returns to the water bodies on the ground. So, this entire process is called as water cycle. Again, we will see the first question. Explain the process of water cycle. First point, one water vapor goes up in the sky and forms clouds. When these clouds cool down, it rains. The water returns to the water bodies on the ground. This process is called water cycle. Now see the second question. Why is it important to use water carefully? So, why is it so important to use water carefully? See the answer. First point, there is a lot of water present on the earth. Yes, 3/4 of our earth is covered with water. Only a small portion of it can be used. Some water is salty and some water is frozen. Yes, but the water that we can use is a less amount of water. Some water means especially ocean, seas we can say. We can't drink or we can't use seawater, right? And some water is frozen, so we can't use this frozen water also. So only less amount of water can be used. That's why we have to use water very carefully. And see the second point. So it is important to save water carefully. This why it is important to save water carefully, because we have less amount of water to use. Now see the third question. What are the sources of water? What are the sources of water? First one, rainwater is the most important natural source of water. So, rainwater is the purest water. This is the most important natural source of water. Rainwater fills ponds, lakes, rivers, wells, seas and oceans. So, this rainwater fills ponds, rivers, lakes, wells, seas and oceans. Some amount of rainwater goes under the ground. We used hand pumps and tube wells to take out this water. So, the water under the ground, to take out and use the water under the ground, we use hand pumps and tube wells to take out this water. So, these are the sources of water. Okay, children. So, read these 3 question and answers 3 times each and note down in your homework books 2 times each, children. Okay, read carefully. If you have any doubts, you can get back to me. Okay, bye, children. Thank you.